What's up, guys? It's Mr. Mechanical Zombie with some more Madden NFL 15 Connected Franchise, and we are at the screen, the regular, like, title screen, kind of. And I wanted to talk about a few things. First of all, while I do this game prep, I'll talk about it, I guess. First of all, somebody suggested that I go ahead and make the quarters a little bit longer because of more realistic stats. And there's two things I kind of want to say about that, and that is, one of them, I agree completely with you, where I think more realistic stats are awesome, but also the fact that some of them will just be, some of the games will be too long, and also it's hard to tell right now for me if it's unrealistic just because it is the preseason. I think if we go through the like the first regular season game and it's still too like unrealistic and like we're only getting like maybe, you know, like 95 yards per like game for our quarterback, that's definitely, you know, unrealistic. So I'll try to work with that a little bit, but right now it looks like I'm just gonna upgrade the quarterback a little bit, try to get Blake Bortles some time. Get out of here, nobody cares about Morris or Henny. Just get Blake Bortles some experience. But somebody else asked me if I could give Victor Cruz. I would give Victor Cruz, but I also don't really want to give Victor Cruz just because of the fact that I want to make it kind of realistic. And to that like point, I don't think the Giants are at a stage at all, like right now at all, in real life, to let go of Victor Cruz, and I don't even think they're going to let go of him in the near future at all. And I just don't see it happening. So for now, I won't. Maybe in like the coming, like maybe in the regular season sometime, maybe I'll pick him up or something. But for now, I don't see that happening. But you know, it could happen somewhere down the line. But for now, I just don't see it happening. So I apologize for disappointing people with some of those things. I think I'm going to go ahead and upgrade. Let's upgrade our safety. Sure. Oh, that's the guy that scored it. Okay, he's the one that picked up the fumble and scored it last game. I think I have one more. No, I don't have enough hours anymore. Okay. So that's all I'm going to upgrade for now. I upgraded the quarterback twice, the left tackle once, and the safety once. So if you're like following along and trying to do it, you can go ahead and do that. I'm not going to do the cuts because I don't like doing cuts. They want me to relocate to Orlando, Florida. Tell me in the comments below if you guys want me to relocate the Jaguars at all in this connected franchise, because I think it's really up to you guys and not up to me to let the relocation process go. So tell me if you guys want us to tell me if you want me to relocate them to Orlando. And I will see you guys in the game in just a second. I will be right back. Alright guys, I am back and we are going against the Lions this week in preseason week 3. I'm trying to get this preseason out of the way as fast as possible because it is kind of annoying not being able to play with our starters the whole game. But I thought that you guys might be interested in seeing some of the preseason games, so I went ahead and just, you know, did it. I don't know who our returner is, but let's hope he can get a good... Oh, I see it! Oh, I tried to spin out of that, but it did not work out too well. You guys might be able to tell I'm a little bit sick, so if you guys hear any sniffling in the background or something like that, that's what it is. Hopefully I don't sniffle too much, but you know, who knows. No, I tried to catch it, but you know, that was overthrown. I lobbed it up there, but they got really good pressure on me there for a sec. Let's go ahead and try to call it. You know, let's run it. We'll run it. Did his knee ever hit the ground? I honestly don't think his knee ever hit the ground, but they called it a dead ball. I don't get that. Oh, well. I guess we'll try the screen here. Coach is suggesting us do the screen. Oh, we got it. Oh, man. Toby Garrett. What the heck is going on with him? He's He's got some weird animations going on right now. he did a front flip or something right there. But offenses are so varied now. You see, I think I'm going to run it right here. Just because this looks like they're going to try to play zone, and I kind of want to run it right up there. Yeah, right up the throat. But we got about 6 yards there. Let's, I don't know if I want to run it this time. It's called play action. Oh, that should have been caught. That was a pretty good throw by Blake Bortles. I wish it was a little bit further back towards the receiver. Because the receiver could have caught that if it was a little bit thrown behind him. But that's okay. We did get the first down right here with Toby Gerhart. Toby Gerhart having a pretty good game right now. 3 rushes for 18 yards. That's not bad at all. It's good because the last few games he's been awful. So, well, I don't even think I've really used him, so I can't really say he's awful. Dang it. I was going to throw at the circle because he was getting wide open, but he came up on that cornerback, the cornerback that was playing to the right, and he completely ruined the play. My receiver just came up, and if I threw it, it was going to get picked off, so I decided not to throw it. And I tried to throw it to X at the last second. It didn't work out. All right, I guess we'll go with play action here. Get the first down. I don't think he got it. Okay, he did get it. Good. That is good. Let's try to run it here. Dante Robinson's in. We'll try the draw. Dang, man. No blocking. No blocking whatsoever. They got to me before I even handed the ball off, honestly. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it. That was pretty bad play by my offense. Dang it. Nothing good. Such a bigger window for the quarterbacks to throw the football now to these receivers. All right, I guess we'll try the screen right here again. If we get lucky, Toby Gerhart might be open again. We'll see. Third down and 8. Well, he definitely wasn't open, but all right, at least he didn't get tackled for too big of a loss. That means that we should be able to kick a field goal here. We might actually miss that. Yeah. That sucks. Sometimes the kicking gets me off track because I think that I don't think it's going to be as fast as it usually as it actually is. I don't know. That's okay, maybe. Matthew Stafford is going to get the ball here. That's not good. Lions offense is pretty dang good, and he is wide open. Oh, my gosh, no. Oh, my gosh. Eric Ebron. That's that Lions offense that I was talking about. They're too good. Their offense is really, really good. As I take a drink of my Coke. Okay, let's try to do something. We have to do something on offense before Blake Bortles gets out. And he's tackled just past the 20. I wish I could have some freaking blockers. Oh my goodness, I never have any blockers to help me. It's pretty much just me. You know what? We are going to go ahead and send Blackman deep. And he's going to be open. And he got it. There we go. Blake Bortles has a perfect throw down the field right on him. Right to him, I mean. Justin Blackman with a good catch right there. Oh, that was a bad throw. I was trying to throw it right over his head to my tight end, but he was there. Red to quarterback and in wonderful position to knock the pass down. Second and 10. Justin Blackman hauls it in. Blackman got another catch. Blake Bortles is about to go out of the game here in a second. Third down on the way. But you know what? I think I actually might Actually, Blake Bortles is still in. No, he's not. Never mind. It said that he was still in for that when they were in the huddle. That's weird. Oh, my God. That's the thing that Chad Henne does. I tried to throw it to the tight end. Chad Henne throws it directly at the freaking linebacker. I don't freaking get that at all. I don't get it. Like, how can you be that bad at quarterback?
Well, this guy's a machine. Every time
he's
gets
awful.
A chance, go out there and kick a field goal, it is right down
on the game. On the game, he's awful. I don't even know. I don't watch the Jaguars, so I don't know how good he is in real life. But I know that on the game, Chad Henne is awful.
The Lions offense now marches onto the field.
All right, let's try to get something done. Matthew Stafford is out, thank God.
First down at the 20.
Oh my gosh! See, that was a perfect throw. Why can't my second string quarterback do that? Chad Henne, why can't he do that? That was on point, great throw by I don't even know Orlovsky. Okay, got the stop. They only got about 2 yards. That's good. Our defense is holding up.
What a job by the defense! They bottle him up for a short game. Nickel formation here for the defense. Bell's taking the handoff, and he's tackled down after picking
well,
up
dang.
The first. Will be it up
I honestly think that we are kind of screwed because Jaguars' second string defense is just awful, and without Blake Bortles on the field, we are kind of screwed offensively. Because Chad Henne just can't throw. But, you know, never say never. It is possible for us to like, claw our way back into this one. Even with just field goals. That was an awful try, that, like, when I tried to tackle with the first guy. That was really bad. I tried to hit stick him, and it just did not work.
They are marching. Let's see how the defense reacts.
Let's, I guess I'll play on Owens here.
The Lions will take the snap from the 30. Bell's hand at the football. Power running.
I want to play a lot of man. Man is like, I like man defense.
This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Let's play man. Let's play underneath.
In the slot.
That way, if they do like short routes, we can stop it somewhat easily.
Space to work.
See, I hit sticks right there, but that really wasn't a hit stick like, at all. So,
short, following the run.
This is going to be a run, I think. Let's crash our linemen.
Getting close to the 2 minute warning. Time for one more
oh,
play.
No.
Back to the ground. Shruts off the first
dude, he broke two tackles.
We've
holy crap.
Here in the first half.
That's that Jaguars second string defense
after the run.
Going to work right there.
Big set here for the defense, lining up in the 4-6.
Okay, let's just try to stop this. Okay, they're going to get a sack here. That's okay. Yeah, flex your muscles. We're losing still, you know. I hate when people do that. They're like, yeah, we're losing. Let's act like we're all big and bad.
He loses yards by taking the sack. He'll take the snap from the gun. Got the completion. Jones is brought down after
okay, so we
six on this play.
We got to gain a six. We have to stop them here. If they get a field goal, it's like it's not good, but it's better than if they scored a touchdown here. So let's just try to stop them on third here. Okay, we stopped them. That's good. That's good. They're going to go for the field goal here. They're going to get it. And then hopefully, I think we got ball first. Sorry if you guys hear my chair moving around. We got ball first, so they're going to get ball in the second half. So we need to try to score before the second half to try to.
And he puts it through for three.
Okay, so we're going to get the ball. Chad Henne, oh God. But, you know, there is one player on our second string offense that is decent. And his name is Denard Robinson, not Dante Robinson. Denard Robinson. And, you know, I don't really want to run it. So hopefully he can get open on the pass like that. Oh, that would have been nice if he could have got that second guy to go to go to the outside as well. Could have spun around him, and then he would have been gone, but that's okay. It's going to be a play action. Oh, no! Turn around and look for the ball. You got to look for the ball, and that was also a bad throw by Chad Henne, which isn't, you know, surprising at all because he's awful. Defense comes out of the nickel. Chad Henne from the shotgun. Good catch. Gets about 9 on the play. I think what I'm going to actually do is for the third quarter, I think I'm going to play Blake Bortles. That was a good throw. Let's call a timeout here. 29 seconds to go. We're going to try to get a touchdown, but you know, if we have to stick to a field goal, then we'll do it. Chad Henne from the gun makes the reception. Dante Robinson, no touchdown, but he got out of bounds. Okay, that's okay. That was a really weird juke. He kind of got his head taken off there, but still did something. Touchdown. There we go. I dove. I thought he was going to jump over, but he jumped in between like three people. There we go. Denard Robinson with the, I keep saying Dante. Denard Robinson with the touchdown. We're going to tie this game up 10-10. There we go. I knew if there was one person I could count on in the second string offense, it would be that guy. I might have to put him in to start over Toby Gerhart. Tate's going to test the coverage here. And it's the same as the Golden Tate, get your butt down, you traitor. The Lions now ready to take over as their offense heads all right, let's to the field. Play two-man under. Let's play underneath. Offense lines up here. I think they're just, yeah, running the clock out. Yeah, they're just going to run the clock out. Second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. All right, well, they're going to get the ball, which isn't a good thing. But if we can stop them, then, you know, there could be some good out of it. Sports halftime report presented by Verizon. Now let's take a look back at the first half. The Lions have had some trouble dealing with the passing game. All right, I don't care. Halftime. Please. I hate when it does this. So annoying. Like, let me skip it, please. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Moving to late in the first quarter, Stafford's going to complete the pass. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and substitute Blake Bortles in for Chad Henne because I do want him to get some playing time before the regular season starts. That goes as a 15-yard touchdown. Lions up by a touchdown. I think they should give you the option before game to choose like when to put your player, your starters out and stuff like that. Instead of just taking them out in the second quarter. I think it'd be cool if they added like that feature in where you can like where they made it like an option, I guess. I don't know. And here we go, the first snap of the second half. One for the deep ball. Right to me, thank you. Why are you running that way? Stays on his feet. I don't know why I cut back. I shouldn't have. But we're going to get the interception. That was a really bad throw by Orlovsky. He could have thrown it to... He could have thrown it to his tight end who was wide open, I'm pretty sure. Okay, Blake Bortles comes in. He's got 98 yards. He only played one quarter, so that's not actually that... That's not that unrealistic. With good play action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense. Let's actually run it here. And now you throw it over the top for the easy completion. Hand off. I just want to see how Blake Bortles can work with Denard Robinson, if that makes any sense. So you have to run the football every once in a while. But I decided to put him in here. See what he can do with this second string offense. Down and six. They'll go ground. Nice tackle. See if he See, if he's a real, like, playmaker, then he can make this second-string offense better without Chad Henne. So. Oh, the touchdown! Denard Robinson, second touchdown of the game. That was a nice spin move to get into the end zone there. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. So it's going to be 17-10. We're going to go up by 7. Denard Robinson making plays like he always does every single time. Did it last game. He's doing it this game. That was a good tackle. Let's go ahead and just play some man. Play underneath man coverage. Hopefully we can get another pick. That'd be nice. Oh, man. I completely botched that tackle. That was really bad. Okay, so I'm going to play as the middle linebacker here. I think this is the middle linebacker. It might actually be the left outside linebacker. Or the right outside linebacker, actually. All right, they're going to get a first down. That's not good, but, you know.
Receivers in this NFL now are so good. It's so easy for them.
All right, so
catch and just keep picking up those first downs.
Let's
and Pettigrew set now, split out wide to the left.
Well, let's go. Brent 38. Brent 38.
First and 10.
Oh, that was so weird. My, the player I was playing as kind of like blitzed, even though it wasn't a blitz for him. That was really strange. Oh, well. It worked out, I guess.
Bells lined up in a single back formation.
No, sir. Orlovsky trying to run. Not going to work out for him too well. I played pretty good coverage right there. There was the Broyles was trying to cut through the middle of the field, and I played right on him just to make sure he couldn't do it.
So I expect the quarterback here to be very conservative with his decision.
Oh, that should have been picked. That should have been picked, but it's okay. It's going to be fourth down. I'm going to have to kick it away. We're going to get the ball. And maybe we can do something off of it. Maybe Denard Robinson can go ham again and, you know, get us another touchdown or something. That would be nice.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Bortles going to take it from the gun. Throws the pass. He's brought down.
All right, so Blake Bortles has 107 yards in two quarters, which isn't that unrealistic, kind of, depending on, like, I mean, Denard Robinson is on fire. Six rushes for 57 yards. That is what I'm talking about. Sorry for the little sniffle there. I apologize, but, you know, when you're sick, you're sick. Seven rushes for 65 yards.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message.
Let's try to pass it to. Let's try to pass it here.
And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
All right, I just ran with Blake Bortles. I actually don't know what his ability to run, like if his ability to run is any good or not. I never really watched him in college, so I don't know. But he seemed pretty fast right there. Like, not too fast, but not too slow either.
Robinson's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. Gets the handle here.
Denard Robinson is going ham this game. Oh, my gosh. That was really good by our offensive line, though, to hold that defensive line back. They couldn't do anything right there.
What a good job by the offense.
Let's go ahead and play a play action here.
First down at the 16. Play fake.
Oh, what the heck was that? Ugh. How do you not catch that? It was wide open.
Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Second down and 10.
Good catch. Good throw.
always a good job to pick up some yards when you're in the red zone. Nice throw by the quarterback.
Why not run it again?
First and goal. Robinson's taking the handoff.
Oh, we didn't get the touchdown there, which is bad, but, you know, that's okay.
You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Second and goal from the four. Finds his mark.
Somehow he caught that.
To be found right there. Nothing too exciting.
All right, let's...
Just plowing ahead. Getting closer to that goal line.
Yeah, they're trying to find out if this
I guess we'll try to run it here.
Denard
Robinson, three touchdowns on the day. He is on fire.
Well, that's really having deep
if this was the preseason, he would have got a team of the week card in Ultimate Team. I mean, if this was like real life, he would have got a team of the week card in Ultimate Team. Because he is on fire. Whoever has Denard Robinson in fantasy would be going crazy happy. Oh my lord, I am so bad at tackling. It's made 24-10. We are up by 14 points, which is good. We should be able to win this one pretty easily now, but you know, things have gone wrong in the past, so.
He'll keep it on the play fake. Brandon Pettigrew with the catch.
Get out of bounds, sir.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
Second down and five. Catch made.
That was a pretty decent tackle. It wasn't like the best tackle. He actually could have got out of that. If that was real life, that would have been easy. He could have like walked over the guy and went. That's okay. We're gonna call this blitz. Maybe we can get something out of it. It's a safety blitz. We gotta have some good corners playing man. Good pick. That is gonna be a pick six. All right, well, that pretty much puts the game away, that pick six. That is pretty much game over. All we have to do pretty much now is sit it out, sit the game out, and wait. That was a good job by our defense. Really bad throw by Orlovsky. I don't know what he was thinking. There was a receiver in the middle of the field wide open, which he didn't throw to. I don't know.
Just past the 20, we'll mark it at the 22-yard line. First down coming up.
But yeah, we're gonna win this one pretty easily. That's pretty strange. Like we lost the first game really badly, and then the last two games have been pretty easy. I don't know why that is. Maybe it's got something to do with. Maybe it'll just get harder in the regular season because we'll be playing like regular season teams with the, like, you know, when Matthew Stafford's in and stuff like that. But I honestly don't know why these last two games have been easier than the other ones. But I guess we'll find out once the regular season hits. If the regular season's too easy, I'll turn it up to all Madden. It's on all pro right now, so we'll see about that.
Dropping back now into the shotgun. Finds his mark. Reynolds there to make the stop. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Holding on to the timeout. They'll rush back to the line.
Another pick.
Ball's picked off.
By the same guy, and he fumbled. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Really? Really? He gets two interceptions and fumbles the second one. That's just pathetic. Should have just went down and kneed it out and just clocked the game, but you know, whatever.
First down and 10.
Okay, he's gonna go out of bounds and stop the clock. That kind of sucks, but whatever.
Well, if you want to be a good play action pass team, it's always nice to have a good running game. Make the defense dig in and try to stop your run.
Game's gonna take a little bit longer than it should.
You fake it,
You throw it down the field, that's about as easy as it gets.
And Evans is there to take him down. First down here after the completion. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. And he hauls it in.
Okay, that was a good tackle.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh.
They're actually trying to hurry up right now. That's pretty crazy.
Over to Pettigrew.
I don't know why. This game is over. I hate when the CPU does, like the computer does this. They're like, yeah, we still have a chance. No, you don't. You're out. You're like down by 21 points.
If you go to an NFL practice, they spend about 40%
you can't score three touchdowns in 1 minute.
Going in to score, that's why not in the NFL. Look so easy here. Nice throw by the quarterback on first.
I mean, they're gonna go for the onside kick here.
They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back.
And then I'm gonna knee it. What's gonna happen as soon as I knee it is they're gonna call a timeout because it's
right around
the computer's pretty stupid like that and doesn't realize that the game's over. Actually, it doesn't want me to knee it. Whatever, we'll just run it. Sure, whatever.
First down. Let's see what they come up with here.
If you like the video, guys, don't forget to leave a like. If you guys haven't subscribed already, I would really appreciate those who haven't would do so. That was a really good run. Holy crap. He broke like 8 tackles. If you haven't subscribed already, I would really appreciate you doing so. That would be pretty awesome of you. Also, don't forget to hit me up on the relocation thing. If you guys want us to relocate to Orlando, tell me. If you don't, just tell me in the comment section. I try to read all the comments. I pretty much do read all the comments. If I don't answer them, then it's pretty much just I don't know. I just sometimes I don't answer them because I don't see an answer to them. I don't know. Not all of them are questions. Some of them are just statements. But yeah, we're just gonna end the game here.
Nickel formation for the defense here. Takes the knee. Third down now.
You mean the last play of the game?
Two tight ends on the field here.
All right, well, that's it pretty much, guys. Like I said, hopefully you guys liked it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button. If you want to subscribe and you haven't already, I would really appreciate it. And I will see you guys later.
Well,
see you guys later, guys.
Have a good day. Winning in prime time.